So let us talk about digital cinema today. In this, we are going to see the history, what is digital cinema, why go digital, the components of this DC types, digital cinema configuration and projection techniques, advantages, disadvantages, application, the future scope, along with the conclusion. Let us see the history. In June 18, 1999, DLP cinema projection in North America. This started with digital cinema. And on February 2, 2000, digital cinema projection in Europe. Right? Digital cinema, this in North America, then digital cinema projection in Europe. In 2002 March, Digital Cinema Initiatives was formed a joint project of many motion picture studios. Then in April 2004, testing of compression technology began. In August 2006, first Indian digital cinema was released. Then January 2007, Guru becomes the first Indian movie in JPEG or digital format. In March 2009, 4K projector start. Then in June 2010, there are 16,000 digital screen. And 2012, 80% of worldwide cinema screen would be converted to digital. And now in 2015, most of the work, most of the cinema has turned digital. So digital cinema, it means the transmission and delivery of films to theaters electronically, where the image is stored in a computer server and beamed onto these theater screens. Right? Digital cinema is again the transmission delivery of films to theaters electronically, where the image is stored in the computer server. And beam onto the theater screen. This is a screen. This is a screen, right? And this image is beamed on. So it uses digital media instead of analog media, the prints, which were used earlier. This digital cinema uses digital projectors instead of analog projectors, right? It uses digital projectors. So why digital? What is the problem? What were the loopholes or drawbacks of analog? See, vision can actually be seen in audiences. Duplication cost is removed. Large number of theaters can now view simultaneously. This transportation cost can be replaced by much lower transmission cost. Just by sitting through internet or through any other network media, you can send the whole movie. Also, it is more flexible scheduling, new entertainment ideas can be incorporated, high quality entertainment because the solid sound picture, because HD, Full HD, Ultra HD, everything is there now, and easier access to screenings. What are the components of this digital cinema? First of all, fiber optics, satellite transmissions also there. Then the projectors, then theater management system, along with the speaker to give a realistic, high-hitting, entertained, or full of entertainment atmosphere. So these are the type of digital cinema: 2D, 3D, 4D, 5D. Now we have 6D, 7D. You know, people are talking about 11D as well. This 2D digital cinema, the pictures cannot jump off the screen, right? It is like the way you see on your laptop or your TV. So feel is behind on the scene and low pitching speed of images is 2D digital cinema you see. And in 3D digital cinema, it provides a perception of depth of image. The images jump off the screen and high switching speed is there. So your audience sitting inside the theater, they actually feel that things are happening and they can relate and they can actually enjoy the thrill of this and all. Then 4D. 3D view is there and 4D effects are also there. Seats are there, seat moves along with the picture, the movie. This is customized, this is made in such a way that seat are moving. The 5D cinema. See, it moves in synchronization with motion in the movie and it is pre-programmed, and at least 6 directional seat movement is required, right? And short duration movies are there, because right now making a 5D movie of 1.5 hour or 2 hour will cost much. So this is digital cinema overview. This is a satellite, right? This is a theater antenna. Now this is theater receiver. This is the storage. This is the compressor or decryptor. And here we have a digital cinema projector which projects. This is the theater speaker management. This is theater management system which handles a network management system as well. So totally this is a network, a kind of internet or a network which is transferring the movies or cinema. So the configuration involves, you have fingerprint, you have compressor encryption, movie and license approved to satellite, then standard geosynchronous AU band satellite is used. The movie, this reception is there, this is how it is uploaded, uplink, this is downloaded, downlink, movie and license download from satellite. And this is given to the cinema Sony projector. And finally, you can see Shah Rukh Khan, Amitabh Bachchan, all those you love star. Then image capturing is also important because professional digital camcorder is required and standard film camera is required. And this is single DMD system. Color images can be made by shining color light onto DMD grid screen image. A light from source bulb is filtered using spinning color. So combination of red, green or blue light is then reflected to optics from this DMD. DMD is very important. This is DMD. This is a board, DLP board, processor, memory head has. This is the shaping lens, color filter, condensing lens. These are the optics, these are light source. And this is how projection lens and this is the screen. So this is how projection is done on the screen. We have three DMD system. Light from the source bulb is diffracted using a filtering prism. Then each color component RGB is reflected from its own dedicated DMD. And this reflected RGB light combine, they combine reflected along the same axis and pass through the optics to display. So the reduced mechanics, no spinning wheel means the system is more reliable, and dedicated mirrors also made higher quality pictures. Let us have just a glimpse of history of digital cinema. These are the security key, these are the encrypted content, these are the key message. So ultimately what is happening, the data is coming, it is in some sort of encrypted version, it is been decrypted and shown on the projector through some theater management system. So digital cinema affects three major areas of movie making: production, distribution and projection. And the advantage of digital cinema is low budget cinema, broadcasting of live conferences as well, limited manpower, automatic scheduling is there, introduction of special effect, occupies less space of course, and the color of image is not corrupted. There are more advantages like addition and deletion of scheme. In the scheme is very easy. You can just crop or delete one scene or other, and simple to handle, fast, images does not degrade. But what are the disadvantages of digital cinema? Projection quality, of course, film-based projector, and high risk of piracy, because if once it is digital, anybody can take it. A single copy can be multiplied in like thousand number of copies and can be sent through internet easily. The application of digital cinema, it is in theater, live broadcasting, and in telecommunication. And now we have, what we are talking about 6D and 7D. In Dubai, we have more than this D in many malls, digital cinema, but they are short. Thank you so much. Hope you got a good idea about digital cinema.